Cunning, masters of disguise, a singular creature housing 9 genius minds within one unimaginably bendy body. An octopus is all this and far more, but...
Our octopus is autistic.
Curious? Then stick around.
We're here at Mission Point Park, and this is a very common place for octopus. And we're here to answer one very interesting question. Well, it all began with an entirely seemingly harmless question. There we were,
sitting around our dinner table, and my sister asked one of her playful questions.
If you were an ocean animal,
what ocean animal would you be? Well, despite my insistence that I would be an aqua boy, everyone else around me insisted that I would be an octopus. So, why would I be an octopus? To which they replied, well, clearly, you act like one. Which led me to a deeper question, and one I invite you to explore with me together. Our octopus is indeed autistic. So it seemed the best way to start in on an investigation like this was to meet one in person. Ready? Let's go.
Oh, side note. Not all us Aspies are very good at depth perception. So, maybe a little bit deeper water next time. There are holes everywhere, indicating lots and lots of life. But when you're searching for octos, there is a very specific type of evidence that you have to search for. We did have the foresight to ask around a little with the local snorkeling crowd, at least the ones that we can manage to get their attention. Once we were able to befriend these people and inform them that we were not here to hunt the octopus, but to film them, local freedivers like Brenda here were more than willing to reveal.
They can be really shallow. I've seen one when I was standing hip deep walking out of the water.
These sacred locations. Yep, they're here all right. So soon, the octopus evidence we were looking for became evident. Once I get my dad's butt out of the way. I used to spend loads of time looking for these creatures until I learned to look for their signs. Ah, there, the telltale sign. Remnants of their victims lie scattered right outside of their dens. During the daytime, octopus are homebodies. Sound familiar?
Me?
What a mess. Just look at these remnants. I wonder if it's watching me right now. Well, no doubts, that's its den.
So that's just one of many homes that we've discovered in this area. And it was a complete unkept mess. Needless to say, me, my room, my life. Which brings us to our first point of similarity. Being very, very messy. We've been scouting this place for a while now. And there has been something that has been innately clear. Here, I want to show you. Check it out. Go up there. Up there. These octopus have homes all over the place, but they're spread very far out. These buggers are clearly loners. Perhaps not the best at making friends either. Much like some of us autistic people.
For example, here's me. And here's a bunch of neurotypical children.
Which leads me to the next point of comparison. Octopuses are complete and utter loners. Whoa! Stingray! Did not expect that. Yeah, I have to shuffle now.
Alright. Now, we can actually get back to looking for octopus. So, finding their dens is a start. But the moment they see anyone approaching, they'll freeze in place and completely blend. It's taken me years to develop an eye for spotting them. But still, you have to get really close. There's one. It's clearly watching us. Watch it. This one doesn't seem overly disturbed by our presence. Oh, I think it's one of those grumpy types. Ah, it's the old grab the camera trick.
Nope.
No, you don't. Octopus have a very short attention span, so if we just flop around a bit up here on the surface. Ah, they're coming out. You see it? Do you see it yet? How about now? That was crazy, right? It took an interest in us, but as you can see, now it's going back about its business. Just like this other octopus we came across. Within a very short period of time, they just go right back to their main interest.
Just look how intent at hunting she is. All eight of her legs, with her brains, are intently focused on hunting and smothering the next creature. Which leads us to our next point of comparison. Very narrow interests.
While I'm certainly not into hunting, Aspie types like me have our own special interests.
You want to ask me. You know you want to ask me, right? Go on, ask. Come on, ask. Oh, so glad you asked. Well, the Mayans and Aztecs invented things like popcorn. The whole idea that Europeans Would you like to know more? Oh! Alright, well there's more on tap where that came from. So, you know, these things have definitely come a long way from their humble snail-like ancestor origins. Which brings us to our next comparison. They're nonconformists. Can we reference towards a part of South Park where the goths are saying,
I'm such a nonconformist that I'm not going to conform with the rest of you.
Nonconformists. Since they've left the bodies of their hard-shelled, snail-like cousins behind, they've taken a completely unorthodox method and approach to everything. That's just how I'm wired. Octopus are so non-definable that they break the testing parameters of those who are even trying to study them.
Take this clever fella, for example. He just unscrewed the panel he's supposed to be squirming through. Nice.
To our species, an autistic person's choices and approach to everything might seem strange, and yet there are often reasons. Good ones. If someone simply steps outside of what their neuro perspective of normal means. Sure, of course you have your autistic who basically make a change so well that the entire scientific organization has to go and rewrite all their scientific books. But for most of us neurodiverse, we are getting creative with all manner of things, like new ways to put on toothpaste. So, these flippers, for example. Some of you might ask, why walk with them onto the beach when most free divers just take them off in the water? Well, I don't want to lose my cameras when I
am out in the water getting blown around in the surge. So I find if I wear my flippers out, I lose far less things like this. Plus, it does make me look a lot cooler than those other neurotypical divers. Now, researchers find that octopus who can excel stellarly at other things are really, really bad at the more mundane things. Like most of us neurodivergent people, outside the box thinking for an octopus comes at the cost of questionable life skill choices. We found that often certain octos will stick around because of their curiosity when they should really be fleeing for safety. Like in one of my fondest early encounters with this little fella.
Oh my god, that thing is so cracking me. Oh look, he's gonna go into that hole.
He really should have been heading for the safety of deeper water.
Oh look, he just put water out of his sight.
But when I put my finger out there,
your finger, but then let him come and investigate, put it down.
He
further.
Couldn't help but to just reach out and grab a little taste. Was I really that trusting of a kid?
Maybe I just have a trusting face. And on that note, here's my final comparison point. Poor time management. And this camera's almost dead.
And that's where the camera battery died.
For the most part, I really suck butt when it comes to time management, but so do my eight-legged friends. Take that fellow over there, for instance. He's now lost track of time again, and now he's stuck in a tide pool again. Oh shoot, those kids are getting really close with that stick. I gotta go lend a hand. Anyway, are octopuses autistic? Food for thought.